It all started with the knots, then smartphone companies came up with these all innovative and crazy ideas like the rotatable cameras, the pop-up and sliding cameras. And then Samsung also has one of these pop-up and then rotatable cameras. Well, in the wake of all these crazy and innovative ideas, Samsung was one of the first to implement a hole-punch display. With their S10 lineup, they managed to cut up a hole on the display to make a room for the front camera. And personally, I do prefer this look, and I've been using the S10 Plus for more than 2 months now, and I just love it. And I'll tell you exactly why in this long-term review of the Samsung Galaxy S10 Plus. So let's just start with the most controversial of things, the hole punch display. We saw plenty of leaks before the official launch of the S10 series, and it was no surprise to see the hole punch when Samsung launched their S10 series. At first, I was skeptical about the idea of having a camera cutout on the screen, but after seeing this thing with my own eyes and after using it for a while, I love this thing. And with these really creative wallpapers, the hole punch got more interesting. It became this thing you would actually adore about your S10 Plus. The Guardian of Galaxy and the Spiderman wallpaper are my personal favorites. And now talking about how much the hole punch affects your experience, for me it was like it wasn't even there. I mean, the display is so good, you won't be taking your eyes off it anytime while watching anything. And most of the time while you're watching anything, YouTube or playing games, your center of attention will be at the center of the display. So after using the phone for a few days, you won't feel the hole punch too much. I think it won't affect your experience that much. So let me just show you how it feels. So let's play PUBG Mobile for a while. Let me start the match, and here we are on the loading stage, and you can see that punch hole slightly affects the HUD because PUBG has lots of HUD elements. Okay, now we'll dive into get some loot, and now as I start playing and focus on the game, it almost feels like the hole punch is not there. And it's similar when you're watching videos on YouTube or Netflix. The hole punch does not really affect your experience at all. Well, I'll say it gives a unique experience. You can also get some third-party apps right now that can make the hole punch act like a battery meter or even act like notification LED, which is not available on the S10 Plus. If you're interested, I'll leave the link of the apps in the description below. And not to forget, you do get these effects when you switch to the front camera or when you're using the face unlock. Well, I don't use the face unlock on the S10 Plus. It is more easy, but it's not secure, so yeah. I just use the fingerprint sensor. The ultrasonic in-screen fingerprint sensor will take some time to get used to, and yes, it is slightly slower than the normal in-screen fingerprint sensor, but the thing here is, you can even unlock if your finger is wet or dirty, which is not the case on the old-gen in-screen fingerprint sensors. So to make the unlock easier, I have added the same fingerprint multiple times, and I do think this trick certainly helps it to be more precise and fast. Now let's talk about the improved display of the S10 Plus. We get a 6.4 inches dynamic AMOLED display with a screen resolution of 1440x3040, and hands down, this is the best display on any smartphone so far. Well, I haven't used the P30 Pro, so let's not say that right now. So there's not much change on the paper, but if you put the previous Galaxy Note 9 or the S10 Plus side by side, it is a very good step up. Well, they have added the HDR10 support on the S10 Plus, and you'll know the difference once you watch the HDR YouTube or Netflix videos. The display is just really awesome. The vibrancy, the colors, and the brightness, all of the things are just top-notch. So in terms of hardware, the S10 Plus is packing a Exynos 9020 with octa-core CPU and Mali G76 Ambitual GPU. The one we have has 8GB of RAM and 128GB storage, and right now this goes for 1,15,000. Yeah, it received a price drop. So this is the top-of-the-line specs, and you don't even need to question the performance. It's fast, fluid, and smooth. App opening, switching between apps, everything is fluid, and with the new One UI, the performance is even more streamlined. I'll just say this much because the performance is really good. So the Galaxy S10 has triple camera on the rear, a normal wide lens, a ultra wide lens, and a portrait lens. It's definitely one of the best cameras, there's no doubt about that. The photos have really good amount of details, the dynamic range is very good, and of course, the popping colors. The photos don't feel as saturated as it used to with all the Samsung flagship. They have certainly fine-tuned the colors on the S10 Plus. We only have 2x optical zoom, and yes, it certainly looks weak against the likes of the Huawei P30 Pro. And matter of fact, it does not have dedicated night mode as well. The night scene built in the AI scene optimizer kicks only when it's too dark, and the results also aren't that different from normal. The night capability have certainly improved from the past, and to be fair, it's good, but of course, it won't be competing against the Pixels or the P30 Pros. And now let's talk about the portrait photos. The first thing you'll notice is that these pictures will have slightly darker profile than the normal ones, but the background blur and edge detection is quite nice. Especially the blur does not seem to be too aggressive, and you can also adjust the blur after you've taken the picture. And you could also use one of these effects such as color point just to make it more fun. But the latest addition, the ultra-wide lens, is what I love on the Galaxy S10 Plus. It just gives you this whole new perspective on photography and things. The way you capture anything is just really interesting. The ultra-wide lens on the S10 Plus is wider than what we have on the P30 Pro. And probably the best thing is you can also take wide-angle videos with it. The wide-angle photos have this distorted effect and is very noticeable with some objects, but there is this shape correction feature which definitely helps with it. Also, one new thing is option to take raw photos. So previously, we didn't have such option on the S10 Plus or the Note 9, but the S10 Plus lets you save the raw copies of pictures. Now let's move on to something that I really like on the S10 Plus, the videos. The best part is it can take 4K videos at 60fps. The video is smooth and I was really impressed with the dynamic range on the videos. They have certainly improved the dynamic range and overall video quality on the S10 Plus. Well, you could also record Asia 10 Plus videos, but of course, there aren't as many Asia 10 Plus supporting devices, so it is kind of not that useful at the moment. But during the period that I've used the S10 Plus, I realized that you can do so much more on the video front with the S10 Plus. Just get a stabilizer, hook your S10 Plus on it, and start making amazing videos. Now let's turn our heads onto the front camera. So straight up, the front camera is really good. The selfies do have plenty of details and you can switch between a normal mode and a slightly wider mode. I'm saying slightly because it's not that wide. The S10 Plus uses a secondary depth sensor on the front. A wide lens certainly would have made more sense though. But the front camera is impressive nonetheless, especially the video from the front camera is really good. And the dynamic range is also quite admirable on the front camera. Let's just watch this video for a brief moment and tell me if it's shot from rear camera or the front camera. So even I was like, what the f-? This is very good. So the 4K video from the front camera is just overkill. It is perfect if you are into vlogging and such, but yeah, you will be spending tons of storage if you capture on 4K. So the S10 Plus rocks a 4100mAh battery, and this is consistently a 1.5 day battery life for me. Well, I don't use my phone too much, but still, the battery life is impressive on the S10 Plus. And now talking about charging, it has a 15-watt fast charger and takes slightly over 1.5 hours to go from 0 to 100. Yeah, the charging speed is slow on the S10 Plus, but I never felt the need for fast charging because it would last me more than a day. And I would normally charge it while I was making my dinner, so I never really felt the need for fast charging. The battery life and the charging was quite alright for me. So overall, I just love the S10 Plus. I love the camera, the display, performance, and everything else. Well, it's a slight bummer that we don't get the same camera versatility as of the P30 Pro, the night mode and the zoom capability. Yeah, it does feel inferior when we bring up those superpowers of the P30 Pro. But on overall, I love the S10 Plus, and especially I have loved taking videos from the S10 Plus. It just feels so wonderful. So yes, on overall, it has been a wonderful experience using the S10 Plus over these past 2 months. And I'll just say that I love the S10 Plus. So that's it for this video, guys. Hope you like it. And as always, like if you like it. Subscribe to the channel for further contents like this. Also hit that bell icon to get notifications. Until next time, namaste. We'll be right back.